In this movie, I'm going to be demonstrating the ability of the dynamic rounded corners tool in VectorScribe version 2 to convert live rounded corner effects into dynamic rounded corners and the advantages of why you want to do this. Let's start by looking at these two simple paths, and the one on the left is a simple star made using the star tool in Illustrator, and the other one on the right hand side is a simple path made up of three Bezier curves. Now I'm going to select both and go to Effect, Stylize, Round Corners. And I'm going to preview this change and click on OK. Now you can instantly see on the right hand side as to why you don't want to apply live rounded corners to Bezier curves. You can see how the strange result sort of corrupts the shape and it isn't really what you want at all. But on the left hand side, the star is made up of simply straight lines, and this tool can cope with that, so it can convert to these pseudo rounded corners. They're not true radii, but it's a rounding effect. Okay, now we have these two selected, I'm going to go to the dynamic corners panel here, click on the tool, and I'm going to use a fly up menu and opt for convert round corner effects. And a warning will come up here, because one or more converted paths included curved Beziers, which is the one on the right hand side. And it's warning us that the appearance will change. Now I could tick on here, don't show again, but I won't do in this case. And click on OK, and it says two paths were converted. And you can instantly see what happens here. On the left hand side, all the roundings in this shape have been correctly converted to dynamic corners. So if I were to click on this one here, it says it is a standard radius, not a true radius, which is a correct radius, but a standard Adobe radius here. And it has correctly recognized each corner in this shape. On the right hand side though, what it has done is actually also converted it correctly, and every single corner radius on all these objects is set to 0.25 inches, but you can see the end effect. It isn't quite perhaps what you expected. That's because if we go back one stage, you can see that the effect isn't correct anyway. So what it's done is in fact correctly applied that live effect. Now if you did for some reason want exactly this effect here, you'd first have to expand the appearance and then see if there are any dynamic corners to convert by using the standard convert to dynamic corners option here. And it says one path is converted, and it has actually converted those sort of strange endpoints like so, but it's got these straight line segments between it. So it depends what you want as an effect, as an end result, but in the standard form, if you convert the live effect, it will probably change appearance if any Bezier curves are involved. Obviously you can also adjust these, so you can see you can get back to the original shape, like so. But it is really up to you as to what you wanted to achieve.